Hello, this is a microscopic slide of a case of papillary thyroid carcinoma or PTC. We have on the left the non-neoplastic thyroid parenchyma, and on the right we have this tumor mass. Let's first do a very quick recap of normal thyroid histology. And we can see that there are many follicular structures of different sizes. When we pay attention to the cells lining the follicles, we can see that they are cuboidal in shape, and the follicular cells exhibit these small rounded nuclei. And when we compare the nuclei in size to red blood cells, for example, there's a red blood cell here, we can see that they are of very similar sizes or diameters. And you can see another comparison here of a red blood cell side by side with a follicular cell nucleus. Let's move on to the tumor. We can see that this tumor is not encapsulated. There is a fibrous area here, but there is tumor present both within the main tumor mass as well as right at the outer edge of this fibrotic area. And at low magnification, there appears to be these papillary-like structures. So zooming in on these, we can see that these are finger-like structures, and we can see that within these papillary structures, right at the core, there is a small blood vessel. So these are fibrovascular cores of papillary structures. Here is another papillary structure. There's a little, small, very slender vessel running within the core. And these papillary structures are lined by neoplastic or malignant follicular cells. Let's do a side-by-side comparison between the malignant cells versus normal thyroid follicular cells. So we can already see that the nuclei are much larger compared to benign follicular cell nuclei. We can also see that the shape is different. Instead of being rounded, the tumor cell nuclei are more oval, so they are more elongated, they are oval. We can see small nucleoli, and as we navigate around, we also appreciate that the nuclear chromatin is very pale. You can see here that it has this ground glass appearance, and when you compare this to follicular cells, the chromatin is somewhat darker in the follicular cells that are not neoplastic. Another important feature that we can see are the presence of nuclear grooves. For example, in this area, we can see a very beautiful longitudinal groove running throughout the length of the nucleus. And we can see another one here. So, yet another one here. So, these nuclear grooves are also very characteristic features of papillary thyroid carcinoma. And yet another nuclear feature, which I will demonstrate on a different picture, is the presence of nuclear pseudoinclusions. So within this nucleus, we can see that there is a little island of cytoplasm, which looks pink, which is the same as the cytoplasm of the cell. And we see yet another one here, a nuclear pseudoinclusion within the nucleus, and another one here. These nuclear pseudoinclusions occur because of folding of the nuclear membranes, so they tend to invaginate and fold inwards, and hence they appear to pick up a little island of cytoplasm. So in summary, we have a tumor that is not encapsulated, that is infiltrating into the thyroid parenchyma, that is composed of papillary structures lined by malignant cells with enlarged oval nuclei with pale ground glass chromatin featuring nuclear grooves as well as nuclear inclusions. And these are the classical features of papillary thyroid carcinoma. Thank you.